r/AskReddit. What is the most terrifying thing you've ever experienced while home alone? I lit two long taper candles for some ambience while I was playing guitar late at night. I was facing the other direction looking out the window while playing, and shortly later turned around and went back towards the candles and discovered one of them was completely gone. The stand was still there, but no melted wax, just a bare candle holder, and the other one was still lit, and no shorter than it was when I lit them. It was almost 3 a.m, and I was so terrified that I got in my car and left and drove to my dad's house. When I was like 14, I was home alone one night around 10 p.m. stood in my kitchen making some cereal. It's dark outside, and then all of a sudden the loudest sound. Some drunk woman literally launched a hammer through my kitchen window. Was so loud and glass was everywhere. I followed her down the street whilst calling the police. Pretty strange. I have been pretty fortunate, based on these comments, that I was home alone one night while my wife and son were visiting my mill. I walked back to our bedroom to see someone rummaging through my son's room on the video baby monitor. Immediately grabbed my firearm and yelled to the other side of the house, "I'm armed. Come out slowly." Over and over while slowly making my way back to his room. Got there, flipped on the light, and nothing. Searched the whole house pumped full of adrenaline. Finally satisfied I was alone, I went back to my room and the guy was back in the room. I took a closer look and I'm ashamed to say I was looking at myself. The camera is a live feed on our Wi-Fi, and it was steaming on a huge delay. I have never known it to do that, and it has not done it since. TLDR, went looking for myself, and came back empty handed. I had the police knock one day while I was alone. The cop had a guy in the back of his car who said we were holding his friend captive. I showed the cop my ID and explained that it was just me and my husband, he wasn't home, but they could look if they wanted to, and he said no, that was okay, and then asked questions about my neighbors. One evening an explosion at a petrochemical plant located a mile from my house blew out the double window in my living room. While I was in the room, I definitely thought we were being bombed, until I remembered where I live. I had just let my dog out to the backyard, and he was completely traumatized. For the following 2 months I had to carry him outside, and sit in the grass with pieces of chicken, just so he would potty. Edit to add, my house is currently for sale for unrelated reasons. Somebody tried to break into the house, while I was by myself. The whole place was quiet and dark at night time. I walked past the front door to go upstairs for bed, and the handle suddenly started jerking around like the Hulk was trying to get in. Then whoever it was started to either kick or shoulder the door, and it was making the whole frame jiggle. I completely froze, and my mind went blank. Just standing there like an idiot and staring. My dog bolted down the stairs, like it was her time to shine, scrambled on the tile, and let loose the most vicious barks I've ever heard. Whoever it was left. She was a very good girl. I miss her. When I was 19 in my first apartment I had someone knock at the door. I looked through the peephole, and saw this burly, heavyset man who abruptly started screaming to let him in. He was screaming things, like he was going to beat my ass, and kick the door down, if I didn't open. I called the cops, and as soon as someone got on the phone he started body slamming my door to break in. I was freaking out and crying as they quickly had 5 cops show up within 5 plus minutes. As soon as he heard the sirens he quickly walked away, and they met him at the bottom of the stairs. Apparently he was after the previous renter, but was extremely intoxicated. They arrested him, and thankfully he never came back. I ended up breaking my lease and moving out 3 months later. It was in a very nice neighborhood, but it quickly made me wish I was back home with family instead of being on the other side of the United States. When I was young, I came home from a party in the middle of the night when my dad were out of town. I started making a midnight quesadilla when I heard someone cough in the basement. I yelled and ran outside, and they took off through the backyard. Come to find out, my dad's ex-GF's daughter stole her key to our house and came to rob us. She was busted a couple years later doing this to her sill. A few years back I was home alone during a power storm. I went into the bathroom to take a dump, and at the exact time I was shitting I sneezed. Well, the power went out as well. The house was pitch black, and I literally thought I shit myself blind. I couldn't see my hand, so in a panic I was yelling, "No, this cannot be true." I was in a panic feeling for the toilet paper to wipe and flush. After completing the task, I just sat on the toilet trying to figure out how to tell everyone I know that I literally shit myself blind by sneezing while shitting. After about 2 minutes of complete darkness and red and panic, lightning struck outside and lit up my hallway. Best damn feeling ever. I was asleep at home alone. When I turned over in bed, I casually opened my eyes a little whilst turning, and they were shut again just as quickly. In that split second, I could have sworn I had seen a man stood at the bottom of my bed. I laid still, awake with my eyes closed, trying not to act like I was awake, and trying to listen for any sound in the room of someone breathing or moving. Couldn't hear anything. I was too scared to open my eyes and look. Consoled myself that there wasn't any way someone could have gotten in without me hearing a window smash, and fell back asleep. When I got up in the morning though, the front door was open. They didn't take anything, and left no signs of being there. Was still very, very creepy though. I was chilling on the couch, doing whatever, when suddenly a really heavy person starts sprinting in our attic. Sounded like steel-toed boots and everything. I'm a really small woman, so I immediately freaked out, thinking there's a gigantic man stomping around my home. Then the screaming starts. Literally screaming, like something from The Exorcist, and there's multiple voices. I sneaked outside and cried, extremely shaken, and called the cops. Guess what's in my attic? Not a big rape why rapist, no. Raccoons. Also, the raccoons were mating. That's what the screaming came from. I bawled to the cops about horny raccoons. Sleep paralysis. Waking up from a nightmare soaked in sweat, with a weight on my chest and completely unable to move. Sometimes I see shadowy shapes, or feel there's someone watching. I was 13 and my dad was at work, and my little sister, then 8, was at my gram's house. My dad and my older sister, then 16, had recently stolen back her dog, the sweetest Aussie Shepherd mix you ever met, from the guy my mom had given it to after she abandoned my older sister on the side of the road. This man did not treat the dog well, and the dog still gets scared before eating to this day. So while I was home alone, the man comes up the driveway and knocks on the door. I gave the 1 minute gesture and then grabbed the dog, literally had to carry her because she hates stairs, and my janky flip phone, and locked myself in the upstairs bedroom to call my dad while freaking out, and then calling the cops and getting mad at them because I was 13 and scared and alone. Edit for clarity. One night I was home alone grilling and chilling, drinking beer and smoking dope, about half lit, wearing my hope clothes. It was a great time. As soon as I sat down to eat, I heard a woman yelling for help and pounding on doors. Once I realized she wasn't a threat to me, I sprinted up the road to find her. She was covered in blood and told me her husband was trapped in the truck he flipped. She kept trying to get me to help her pull him out of the truck, and I said, "Lady, I know this is an emergency, but I ain't no EMT." The worst part was I live in the woods with no cell service, but luckily I was able to get to my landlord's attention, so he could call 911 from the landline. I was up until 3 a.m. that night, because I could not wind down after the fact. Everyone survived and the guy got out on his own, but it was the scariest night of my life. Nothing quite that terrifying yet, please age well. But once I left all the bathroom windows open wide by mistake, when it was very windy, and I woke up in the middle of the night to the bathroom door slamming open and shut, and felt like I was gonna piss myself with fright. I stayed in bed, like I was paralyzed, and I could feel this cool breeze coming into my room, all the cold air being let in low. I prayed to whoever above to remove who or whatever it was from my home, and asked for my life to be spared. Yes, I'm a rockin' pushy y'all. I got under the covers and called my aunt and asked her to come over as she had a spare key, and she did. Her and her husband came with weapons and charged upstairs into the bathroom, no fear. They realized it was the wind pushing the door around. I still stayed with her that night, lol. I was home for the weekend from uni, but my parents and siblings were away, so was home alone. Our house is quite secluded, with a church and graveyard next door and closest neighbors up the street, but quite a bit away. I had all the doors locked, and was settling down to watch a movie, when the doorbell starts to ring, so I go to answer it, no one there. Then the back doorbell rings, no one there again. This keeps happening over and over, and it is pitch black outside. Then whoever it was began banging on windows, and yelling. At this point I'm freaking out, so I begin to call the police, and yell at the people outside, that I've called them, when it turns out it was a couple of fellas from uni playing a prank on me. I was terrified and reduced to tears at this point, but they thought it was hilarious. They did a few more things like that to me over the 2 to 3 years I was at uni with them, and I always thought they were my friends. I'm older and wiser now to know that they were just cunts. One afternoon someone knocked at my back door. I thought it was the guy coming to read our meter, so I opened the door. Next thing I know, two huge guys pushed into the house, and one of them threw me up against the wall. Then they shoved me down on the couch. They told me they were Hell's Angels, and they were pissed because my BF was selling too much drugs, cutting into their profits. They kept calling me by my next door neighbor's name. We had suspected they were selling drugs. All of the people stopping by for less than 5 minutes made it pretty obvious. I just kept telling them I wasn't her. One of them searched the house, while the other kept me pinned to the couch. They started to realize they were in the wrong house, because they couldn't find anything where they were told it was. My neighbor's house is a single floor, with a basement. My house is a 4-level, backsplit. Then I showed them my mail, because it showed my name, and they knew they ucked up. They started telling me that they were after my neighbor's BF, because he raped their cousin. Which I knew was BS, but I didn't care, I just wanted them to leave. They robbed me of my cash, and left. I now have locks on my screen doors,